Energizing your soul through the inspired word of God. This is your daily devotional reading.
Maranatha, the Lord is coming. A devotional by Ellen White. May 21st, the violent earth. Kingdoms at their base are crumbling. Hark, his chariot wheels are rumbling. Tell, oh, tell of grace abounding. While the seventh trump is sounding, lo, he comes. Lo, Jesus comes. Lo, he comes, he comes, all glorious. Jesus comes to reign victorious. Lo, he comes. Yes, Jesus comes. The violent earth. I beheld when he had opened the sixth seal, and lo, there was a great earthquake. Revelation chapter 6, verse 12. Prophecy not only foretells the manner and object of Christ's coming, but presents tokens by which men are to know when it is near. The Revelator thus describes the first of the signs to precede the second advent. There was a great earthquake, and the sun became black as sackcloth of hair, and the moon became as blood. These signs were witnessed before the opening of the 19th century. In fulfillment of this prophecy, there occurred in the year 1755 the most terrible earthquake that has ever been recorded. Though commonly known as the earthquake of Lisbon, it extended to the greater part of Europe, Africa, and America. It was felt in Greenland, in the West Indies, in the island of Madeira, in Norway and Sweden, Great Britain and Ireland. It pervaded an extent of not less than 4 million square miles. In Africa, the shock was almost as severe as in Europe. A great part of Algiers was destroyed. And a short distance from Morocco, a village containing 8,000 or 10,000 inhabitants was swallowed up. A vast wave swept over the coast of Spain and Africa, engulfing cities and causing great destruction. It was in Spain and Portugal that the shock manifested its extreme violence. At Cadiz, the inflowing wave was said to be 60 feet high. Mountains, some of the largest in Portugal, were impetuously shaken, as it were, from their very foundations. The earthquake happened on a holy day when the churches and convents were full of people, very few of whom escaped. It has been estimated that 90,000 persons lost their lives on that fatal day. How frequently we hear of earthquakes and tornadoes, of destruction by fire and flood, with great loss of life and property. Apparently, these calamities are capricious outbreaks of disorganized, unregulated forces of nature, wholly beyond the control of man. But in them all, God's purpose may be read. They are among the agencies by which he seeks to arouse men and women to a sense of their danger. Maranatha, the Lord is coming.
I encourage you to be ye doers of the word and not hearers only. Thank you for listening, and be sure to join us tomorrow for your daily devotional reading.